Yeah, I'm sort of ready to just start for real, and we'll probably have to tweak it. Hello, my name's Dr. Tas van Ommen, and I lead the climate program for the Australian Antarctic Division. Before too long, where I'm sitting will possibly be the most remote kitchen table in the world. We're putting the finishing touches on this dining van. This is part of the new Antarctic tractor trains being assembled here in Hobart. In the next few years, the Australian Antarctic Division will launch a new inland traverse. Our ice core drilling team will travel by convoy 1,300 kilometres from Casey Research Station deep into the interior of Antarctica, high on the ice plateau. It'll mean travelling 10 hours a day for 2 weeks at a speed of 10 kilometres per hour or so across the featureless white Antarctic ice cap. It may not be five-star dining in here, but this van will be a safe and cosy hub for a small team working in the most extreme conditions imaginable. Our mission? To retrieve ice cores more than a million years old. The ice of Antarctica is like the pages of a diary. Every hour, day, year, every century, the snow that settles on Antarctica traps minute traces of dust from distant storms, acid from large volcanoes, salt blown far inland from the ocean, and other chemical signatures that reflect temperatures, even the activity of the sun. As the snow is buried year after year, it gets compressed to ice, and as it does so, it captures one last highly valuable thing. Small pockets of air in the porous snowpack are trapped as air bubbles, and these bubbles become time capsules of the atmosphere from the past. So the deeper we go, the older those time capsules get. That's what the Million Year Ice Core project is all about. This ambitious science mission is Australia's contribution to one of the biggest international collaborative efforts ever undertaken in Antarctica. When complete, it will see two or more deep ice cores retrieved that extend our climate records well beyond a million years. But why does a million years matter? And why is this large project important? And why are so many international projects attempting to do this? The answer lies in the amazing power of ice cores to tell us about the past, and in a major scientific puzzle that remains at the heart of climate science. If we can answer this, we'll have a much clearer understanding of the long-term course that our climate is destined to take in response to human impacts. The ice of Antarctica has built up over millions of years and become a sort of time machine that we can drill into to learn about the past. As ice is buried, it slowly flows towards the coast where it breaks off as icebergs and melts into the ocean. So the original ice from many millions of years ago will be long gone. Still, for the slowest moving ice at the centre of Antarctica, the oldest layers, around 3 kilometres deep, are likely to be over a million years old. So far, the oldest ice core we've got takes us back to around 800,000 years. Among the many things we've learned from ice cores, perhaps the most critical is the incredible connection between CO2 and temperature. As we look back in time over 800,000 years, we see the Earth's climate swing from cold ice ages to warm interglacial periods, like today. The average temperature of the planet in an ice age is about 4 to 5 degrees colder than present. As it changes from colder to warmer and back, we see CO2 levels in the atmosphere moving in lockstep. This shows us how tightly climate and CO2 are linked. In the recent CO2 rise of the last century or so, we see how levels have risen far beyond anything seen in the 800,000 years, showing us how humans are making change on a planetary scale. Which brings me to the big questions that ice older than a million years can answer. It lies in those pulsing cycles of ice ages, like the planet's heartbeat. We see in the 800,000 years of ice core record that these cycles beat with an interval of 100,000 years or so. But this was not always so. Deep ocean sediment cores show that before about a million years ago, ice ages came on a shorter cycle of just 41,000 years. Even though the Earth a million years ago looked pretty much the same as today in geological terms, something changed which caused this change in the rhythm of the ice ages. And we don't know what it is. If we can get an ice core record that captures this change, we can find out what role CO2 may have played. Did it still move in synchrony with temperature? Were levels higher than during the past 800,000 years? We think possibly yes. We will also get a more detailed look at a time when the climate system was overall a bit different. The ice ages were weaker as well as shorter. All of this information is important if we are to understand what the very high CO2 world we are now in will lead to in the long term. It's with this in mind that the 24 nations who form the Global Ice Core Community set the goal more than a decade ago to recover ice cores as old as possible from Antarctica. By getting multiple cores, this global oldest ice challenge will allow us to push to the limit of what's achievable and verify what the oldest and deepest layers can tell us. Several nations have formed a joint European effort. Australia is leading another. Japan has a project underway, and so does China. All of these countries working together will give us the best chance of finding the most suitable drilling sites, recovering the ice, and extracting its secrets. We look forward to starting drilling in the next year or so and expect to recover the oldest ice from nearly 3 kilometres deep in around 2025. Personally, I can't wait to see what the ice time machine can tell us about how things are going to be different in the future than they were in the past. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a like and subscribe to our channel. Good coach. Thanks.